Hello viewers, how are you? Welcome to my channel Saint Linux. I am here again with a new video in our Rocky Linux 9 series. In today's video we will see how to install and set up an Ansible control node on Rocky Linux 9. Well, first of all I wonder some of you don't know about Ansible. So let me start with saying something about Ansible. So what is Ansible? Ansible is a configuration management system and it is now become the core part of RSCE certification. So if you are going for the RSCE certification, then it is mandatory that you have a good command over Ansible software and you know how to execute ad hoc commands and create Ansible playbooks. And for writing Ansible playbooks, you are also required to have a good understanding of YML markup language. Basically, the playbooks of Ansible are written in YML language. So if you want to create your own playbooks, then you have to understand the YML language. Also, the biggest advantage of Ansible against other competitor software, for example Puppet, Chef, SaltStack, etc., is that the Ansible is agentless. That is, what does it mean by agentless? It means you don't have to install an agent software on the managed host. You just simply required the SSH access of the managed node and the version of Python installed thereon. So you can get complete access to that managed host and configure it by using Ansible very easily. Also, the Ansible uses the markup language YAML for writing playbooks and it is very simple and very easy to understand. So you don't have to understand and read a completely new scripting or programming language like the other configuration softwares, that is Puppet, Chef and SaltStack do. So let's start with configuring our Ansible control node. I have provisioned a Rocky Linux 9 machine and now I am starting configuring the Ansible software over it. First of all, check the version so you can be sure that what operating system I am using here. Okay, I am using Rocky Linux 9. Then what is the Linux kernel version? It is the latest 5.14. Okay, now set the host name. Okay, the host name is set. You can verify it by executing hostname command. Now for proper functioning you need the proper name resolution for your control node and the managed nodes. It is better that you have a private DNS server for your network, so you don't have to configure name resolution on each system. However, I am demonstrating this video in an isolated environment, so I don't have a DNS server here. So I am using the local DNS resolver for this purpose. open vi.host file in vim editor and add an entry therein about your IP address. Then the host name and then the FQDN of your host name. Write and quit. Named resolution has been done. You can check by ping control. Okay, it is pointing to your IP address and working fine. Now the named resolution has been completed. Okay, start installing Ansible now. In Rocky Linux 9, the Ansible software is available in the default YAML repositories. Unlike Rocky Linux 8 and CentOS 8 operating systems, where you have to install it separately from other third-party repositories or by downloading the RPM file from its official website. You can see the Ansible in installing, and it is also install the dependent software packages here with. It takes some time because it's installing a couple of packages. Okay, it's about to complete. Okay, Ansible is installed. Verify it by checking the version of Ansible command. Okay, Ansible Core 2.1.2.1 has been installed on our machine. Now, add a Linux user with name Ansible or something else, whatever you like. It is the main management user that you will use throughout your network, and this user will be created on all managed nodes. Okay, Ansible user create, set a password for it. Okay. Now we need to give it the sudo permissions, because by using this user you have to install the packages, make configurations in administrative configuration files, create users, etc., etc. So it is necessary that this user must have the sudo rights on each system. So by considering that our control node is also a managed node, because we can execute commands, configure it by using the Ansible itself. So grant sudo privileges to this user. For this purpose, I have a very simple command that you can simply execute, and it will add an entry in the sudo file. Okay, it's done. Now the Ansible use also has the sudo permissions. It is also a good practice to create the key-based authentication among the systems. So when you execute the playbooks or ad hoc commands, you don't have to provide a password each time. So how we can do that? Simple. Use the SSH keygen command. But first of all, switch to Ansible user, because we are setting the environment for Ansible user. So switch to Ansible user, then use SSH keygen command to generate a public private key pair. Press enter, go on with the default setting. Do not provide any passphrase here. It's done. Key has been generated, key pair has been generated for your Ansible user. Now copy this key pair to your target system. And what is our target system? In our case, our control node is also our target system. So we can SSH copy ID Ansible at control. Save the fingerprints, provide the Ansible password. It's done. Now you don't have to SSH access to our control node as a Ansible user. Check it out. Okay, it is not asking for any password, and it's simply login to our target node as a by using SSH. Okay, go to the home directory of the Ansible user and create a bash directory. Well, it is not necessary to create separate directories for projects. It is also not required if you are managing a simple compact environment, or you have limited of managed host. The main files that are located in etc Ansible directory, there are two files, ansible.cfg files that has the configuration related to Ansible software, and the host files. Host files contains the inventory of the of your network. What is the inventory? The inventory is consists of the hosts and the host groups. You can define your managed host in this file, and then by using Ansible you can execute commands and playbooks on those hosts and host groups. So these files are already created when you install Ansible core. But if you are managing different environments and you are managing different projects, then it is a good idea to create a separate directory for each project, so the file can be managed separately. Okay, we have created the bash directory. Okay, now create a inventory file here. You can name it differently, but it is the default practice and rule of thumb that we named it as inventory. Okay, so what you have to write in this file? Usually we put the host name of the machines here and then create host groups of related machine. For example, if you have two Apache servers, then you can join them as in a host group name Apache or web or something else. If you have MySQL machines, you can combine all them in a single group name DB or something like that. Here I have created a dummy inventory file, so I am adding its entries in this file. Okay, here are three machines: control, Ansible 1, Ansible 2. These are three managed hosts. Then we have created a control host group name web, and there is only one machine that fulfills the criteria of this host group, so I write it there. And then we have another group named DB, and Ansible 2 lies there. Okay, the Ansible 1 and Ansible 2 machines are non-existent. I have just write it down here to demonstrate how we can create it here. We are doing all our work on our control machine. Okay, write and quit. Now create the Ansible configuration file for your project. Use VI editor and create this file. I have also saved version of entries in this file, so I copy paste it here. The directives are self-explanatory and already set according to our environment. Write and quit. Okay, now our project directory has been set up successfully. Use Ansible inventory command to check what is available in our inventory. Good. @all, it is the main node of the tree and it contains all available machines in our inventory files. Then there is the host group DB, it contains Ansible 2. Then there is a host group @ungrouped. These are the machines which are not assigned to any host group, and that is our control node. And the last one is the @web, where Ansible 1 is available. Okay, our inventory file is accessible. Okay, accessible, and we can say that our Ansible configuration for this project has been done successfully. So now how we can use this project? We can execute ad hoc commands. Writing playbooks will be demonstrated in a separate video, because that is a lengthy topic and I want to stick to the scope of this video and not want to include the playbooks writing and YML in this video. Okay, let's execute some ad hoc commands. Ansible is the main command that is used to execute ad hoc commands here. The all means execute this command on all machines, all hosts. And /m means module. Basically Ansible works on modules. We have different modules and each module provides some functionality. So we use modules to achieve a certain functionality. Here we use the ping module to check the connectivity and the manageability of the of the managed nodes. Okay, let's see. Good. Control node is success. Okay. Good. It is the output is okay. There is no problem because Ansible 1 and Ansible 2 are non-existent, therefore they are not unreachable. Whereas the control node is giving the success flag. Okay. Let's install something on control node. This time we are giving the name control node. So we want to execute this command only on control node. For installation, we know that we have yum module. And for executing the command, use the -a/ and provide what do you want to execute. The name of the package is bash completion and its required state is latest. So how it sum up? Let me sum up for you. The name equals to bash completion provides the name of the package that we want to install and what state we want this package in. We can use the state removed if we want to remove this package. we can use the state install if we want to install the available version. However, the in most cases we prefer to use the state latest, so it can install the latest version of the package. Okay, let's see what it do here. Good, done. The control pipe sign change. It means that the state of the control node is changed. The changed flag has been returned when the Ansible performs some action on the managed hosts. If it is unable to perform an action or the managed host not requires that action, for example, if I execute this command, the same command again, okay, now it is giving success. Success means the target machine is already in the required state and there is nothing has been changed, so the both outputs are okay and the best completion package has been installed on our control node by using Ansible. Okay, you can also check it by using local commands. Good, it is now available here. Okay, Ansible playbooks will be discussed in our future videos. For right now, I am also giving you a little idea about the collections. A collection is a group of modules, Ansible modules. We have already seen Ansible depends upon the modules. Each module provides a certain functionality. For example, we have used the yum module for installation and uninstallation of software packages. We have used the ping module for checking the connectivity and manageability of the Ansible node. So we have many thousands of modules available for Ansible. Some of them are installed by default with the Ansible cores, and some of them we have to install from their official store or websites, that is Ansible Galaxy. For installing collections from Ansible Galaxy, we have the Ansible Galaxy commands, or you can also download the package from their websites. But definitely installing by using this Ansible Galaxy command is very much simple. Okay, Ansible Galaxy collection install ansible.posix. We are installing the ansible.posix connections. This collection provides many useful modules. For example, firewall D that is used for managing the firewall D daemon on the Rocky Linux 9 or 8 machines. Okay, ansible.posix collection has been installed. You can verify it by query the Ansible Galaxy collection list. Okay, so you can check that Ansible POSIX has been installed on our system. We will use it in future video for writing some playbooks for our Ansible managed machines. Now use the Ansible command to send an ad hoc command to shut down the machine. Okay, we want Ansible to send power of command on control node. Okay, the machine has been down. Okay, we are now completed our Ansible node configuration, and in future we will use this node for managing our Ansible nodes. For now, goodbye from me. And if you like this video, please subscribe my channel so you can receive my future videos notifications, and also like this video. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.